طيب الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. I'm very happy to see new faces all the time. And good morning Berlin, good morning Cologne.
This is Sister Hafiza, Cologne.
Where is Frankfurt?
Frankfurt is here. Frankfurt is not still here. Munich is here.
Hamburg.
Now we're in Germany, we are with Hamburg, with Frankfurt, with Munich, Bayern Munich, and others. So very happy to be with you today, and I'm very glad that I'm here. What's the talk of today? What you want to say? And the talk of today is the donation that we receive. There's two kinds of donations. A donation which the community can count for you, which if you have a millionaire, like brother Mahmoud, and they give you $1 million or €1 million. You got a poor sister, like Sister Simona, and she gave you €30. Well, both of them will be equal to another, €1 million, €30. Well, both of them will be equal. The community will measure the €1 million. Okay? But they might not measure the €30. But the €1 million before Allah could be some of the saving of the millionaire who have got a few hundred million euro. But the €30, the €300 could be the salary of Sister Simona. When we put them on the scale, the salary of Sister Simona is feeding her family. The saving, a part of the saving of Mahmoud, is just a part of his reserve. The community will measure Mahmoud high, but will look at Simona, yes, thank you. But Allah will measure it differently. Allah will look at Simona that she is cutting the income of the family and letting them to have less food, less facilities for a month or two. But Mahmoud is not affected. So the €30 could be more valuable than the €1 million in the hands of Allah. But in the hand of the community, Mahmoud's contribution will be more than your contribution. What I say, we need more. We need both of them. Because barakah comes from Simona, okay? And wealth comes from Mahmoud. So I want to marry both of them together, not Simona and Mahmoud. I mean, the man is not euro, because I booked you already. Run away from me. So when you look at it this way, never ever undermine the little donation come from a poor man. The Prophet ﷺ said, the best sadaqah, is the effort of the poor to help the needy in secret. أحب الصدقات هي أو أفضل الصدقة هي جهد المقل إلى فقير في سر. German.
Die beste Spende, die sind kommen von der Mann, der sehr Bedarf an dieser Spende hat, und der macht das für eine Bedürftige in Frühstück. Das heißt nicht in die Öffentlichkeit.
That's why when the poor people, poor Muslims came to the Prophet in Medina, wearing nearly no clothes, very hungry, thirsty. Prophet, his face became red and he was so angry, he wants some food for them, some help. Every good individual in the city, like you brought some dates, somebody brought some wheat, somebody brought some money, gold, clothes, whatever it is. But one man, was sitting at home crying, very upset, telling Allah, oh Allah, I have no money to give. I have no food to give. I have no clothes to give. But I give my honor and my dignity to any Muslim. If he or she backbite me, insult me, I forgive them. تصدقوا عليك بعرضي فمن سبني أو شتمني أو اقتبني. Next day the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came to tell the Muslims, who is the man of charity? They thought that this is Brother Mahmoud because they gave the gold, or Sister Simona because they gave the wheat, or Brother Tariq because they gave what? The clothes, or you give the flour. Said, no, 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 no. It was somebody else. It was Abu Damdam, who said, I have nothing to give but my honor and dignity, which is more valuable than the wheat, the gold, the silver, the cloth. This to complement the story of Mahmoud, the millionaire, and Simona, the worker who feed 5 children at home, okay, from her salary, which may be 1,000 euro a month. You know, value the little contribution to get the big contribution. Value the euro to get the billion euro. Value the poor to get the rich to respect you. Because your testimony before Allah, or our testimony before Allah, will come from the poor, not from the rich. The one who will stop us to go to heaven, to hellfire, and push us into heaven is those little miserable children, or old women, widows, or sick man, who will say, Allah, no, 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 no. No, no, I know him. I support him. Leave him alone. I know her. I support her. Leave him alone. So Allah will respond to the poor and to these miserable people. And the other hadith of the Prophet ﷺ said, رُبَّ أَشْعَثٌ أَغْبَرْ مَدْفُوعٌ بِالْأَبْوَابِ لَوْ أَقْسَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ لَأَبَرْ. Maybe this dusty haired man, whose hair is of dust, very bad clothes, if he comes to marry you, you will never open the door for him. He looks miserable. If he comes to knock your door for a meal, you will never let him in. But when he goes back, he will make a dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah swiftly will respond to him. Those people will be your testimony. Not the chancellor, not the prime minister, not the president, not the queen, not the king, not the billionaire or the millionaire, or the trillionaire. We are here to serve our employers. And our employers are those poor people. I love you. Do you love me? What do you think? Love Mahmoud because he's more handsome than me. Pause. Because when we do our social media, we pause. Finished. That's my 10.5%.